Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily, and today I have part 5 of my series. Today we're going to be talking about popular series that I have not read. And these are ones that have been kind of vaguely on my radar, but I just haven't decided whether or not I want to read them. So my challenge for you is to let me know in the comments which ones you think either I shouldn't miss or ones that you think I would really like based on my reading tastes and things that I enjoy reading if you've watched other videos of mine. So we have 5 series to talk about, and these are in no particular order, so we will just dive right in. The first is the Throne of Glass series by Sarah J. Maas. I have never read any Sarah J. Maas books. I have no interest in A Court of Thorns and Roses and that whole series. With the finale of the Throne of Glass series recently being published, Kingdom of Ash, and everyone like losing their mind about it, I feel more inclined to want to try that one. I know nothing about it, but I, in general, have like pretty neutral, bordering on negative feelings about Sarah J. Maas. She seems a little problematic, and I'm not sure that I will enjoy them, but for some reason, Throne of Glass seems like something that I might like. I know Paolini from Caffeinated Reads started the series earlier this year and loved it, and she got super invested right away and was binging it. It's the kind of series that I feel like you could totally binge. There are 7 books, I think. I'm like, kind of interested in that. Let me know if you think I'd like it or if you think I should skip it. Number 2, I have the Eragon series by Christopher Paolini. I never got super into this series, even though it came out when I was younger, when like I was the intended age of that book. I don't know, something about it just never drew me in. I know Adam has read it, the whole series, and loved it. And yeah, I'm curious to see more about it. I know it's about a boy who like discovers a dragon or something to do with the dragon. There's dragons on the covers of all of the books. How to Train Your Dragon is one of my favorite movies, so if you think that means I would like it, let me know. Number 3 is the Selection series by Kiera. I'm actually really intrigued by this one, and the Selection, the first book in the series, was free on Kindle the other day, so I did pick it up because why not? And this seems like sort of a dystopian, utopian, futuristic society, kind of along the lines of Matched or Uglies, Pretties, that series. I really liked that series when I read it in probably middle school or high school. This one, I think, like the prince or king or someone is able to select a wife, and it's definitely the genre or type of book that I loved in the past. I see this series on Book Outlet all the time, and I'm always super curious, and I kind of want to pick it up, but I just never have because I'm not totally sold on it. I'm always looking for good, like, super bingeable series. If it seems like something that I could do that with, definitely let me know, because I am really interested in that. Number 4 is the Graceling series by Kristen Cashore. This one seems like, you know, princess royalty fighting against the government or something to that effect. Obviously, I know nothing about any of these series, but all of them are ones that I have put on my Goodreads TBR at one point or other, and so they were interesting to me at some point, and I just have kind of lost track of them since I did so. But Graceling seems like it's pretty hit or miss, so I'm really curious what all of your thoughts are on Graceling, if you've read it. And then finally, number 5 is Red Queen by Victoria Aveyard. Again, this is one that I got super hyped about earlier on in the year because the fourth and final book, War Storm, came out, and it is giant. It's like 1,000 pages or something ridiculous. People lost their minds over it again. Really, really loved it. And this one, again, I love fantasy stories that have to do with like royalty and maybe like a jilted prince or princess or something, queen. I don't know. I am really drawn to the like royal storyline and that sort of narrative. And this one I have wanted to read for a really long time and just have never purchased it, never gotten it from the library or whatever. Just timing has never been right, I guess. But I'm really curious about it. But I also feel like at this point, like, am I too late to the game? Will I not like it anymore? I don't know. Obviously, these are all YA series, I think. And if you have any suggestions for adult series that you think I would really enjoy, other than like Brandon Sanderson or Patrick Rothfuss, I am desperately in need of some more adult literature in my life. I love me some YA, but just, it's time to transition a little bit. Thank you so much for watching this video, even though it was me basically just telling you five series that I know nothing about and asking you to convince me either to or to not read them. But I really value your opinions, and I would love to hear your thoughts on why I should or shouldn't read these series, especially if you think that they particularly fit in my reading tastes or whatever. You can also find all the links to my social media accounts in the description box if you would rather connect with me there. And if you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on my next video. But until then, happy reading. Bye.